Hello, this is Robert from eMarketeer. You may have heard that we are introducing a new email system for sending emails. That means faster sending speeds, improved deliverability, some more details in the report, and some other technical stuff. Luckily, it doesn't mean a lot of changes for you as a normal eMarketeer user. While improving the mechanics of sending the emails, you are still building the emails the same way that you have always been. Mainly this is about what happens after you press send. But there's a few things that you need to know to get started to migrate from the old system to the new system. Don't worry, it won't happen overnight. You have control over when this is done. So watch this video. There's a few things that you need to do, and I'll talk you through them right now. And then you can activate the new system when you're ready. So the first thing I'm going to talk about is the difference between the old system and the new system. Then there's a thing that you need to do called authenticate your domain. I'm going to explain what's that all about. And the third part is a step-by-step guide how you authenticate your domain. As an eMarketeer user, the biggest change will be about the email from address. That's where you get to say who is the email from when you send it. And currently in eMarketeer, you can type just whatever email address there that you want. So yeah, you could type and say that the email is from a different company. That is of course a security problem for the receiving end. They want to know for sure that the email is coming from the same company that the email claims it to come from. So the new email system is a bit more strict on which email from addresses that you can use. And in return, you will send 100% fully authenticated and verified and identified emails. So not only does that affect the deliverability just then and there when you deliver the email, fully authenticated, but it will also, since you are doing this 100% of the time, also increase the long-term deliverability and your reputation as an email sender. Okay, so this is what it will look like when you normally use eMarketeer. Just a glimpse on your daily work. In this scenario, all your domains that you want to use are already authenticated because that's a one-time setup and then you can use it forever. So normally you would go into your campaign, you would click add an email. Email, I'm just going to call it email, subject, this is my email. From name, still the same as before, your company name or personal name or something like that. Company Inc. The next part is what I've been talking about, that's email from address. Previously you could type anything. Right now you need to start typing whatever is in front of the @ character in the email address, like Robert in this case for me, or newsletter, and then you select in the drop list of domains that you have already authenticated. So you cannot deviate from that list, and you can add more domains to that list. I will show you soon. You have the option to type a reply to address, which is not the from address, but if someone hits reply, that's the address the email will go to. Mainly newsletter at this leadexplorer.dk, that's a domain I have authenticated. Pick a template and I head into the email. Once you're in the email, you see the same changes here. You have the prefix of the from email address and you have the list of authenticated domains. That's mainly the only change as a user that you will encounter. If you don't find the domain in the list, you need to add one. Okay, so now I'm going to show you how to actually authenticate the domains. Right now, you may be on the old email system and you have access to the part where you do the authentication part, because it's a good idea for you to authenticate the domains that you know that you are going to use before you actually switch over, so you don't have to do everything at the same time. So once you migrate to the new email system, the domains will already be authenticated and your users will just need to select them from a drop list. To do that, you head over to the betting account and you click email domain. Then you will end up on this page where you will find the email domains that you have already authenticated, or you can also start the new authentication. You will also end up on this page if you are in the new email system and click add email. You don't find what you want here and you click on add custom domain. That takes you to the exact same page. So if you're on the old system, the only way to this page is through the account settings and email domains. So once we're on this page, we need to add the domain that we want to authenticate. And the process actually means that you need someone to make changes to your DNS. That's the domain name server, which carries the configuration for your company domain or all the domains that you have. Someone has access to that at your company. You may be the one who does it, but it may just as well be someone else. So we start by clicking add a domain. In this case, I want to authenticate leadexplorer.se. Then I click add. And now I get instructions on data that I need to add to my DNS to authenticate it. If you scroll down on this page, you need to get this information to someone who can make changes to your DNS. And at the bottom, if you don't intend to do it yourself, you can click here to generate an email. It creates a nice email ready to be sent to your IT department. Hello, IT department. We are using a new email service provider. So all you need to do is type the email of someone at your IT department who can do these things. So once they see these value pairs, they know what to do. So now you send it. So once you have sent the email, you are waiting for the, okay, we have added the records to our DNS. Once you do that, you click authenticate at the far bottom right of this dialog. And when you click authenticate, it will look in your DNS and see if all the changes are made and if everything is done correctly. You will have an authenticated domain. So I can close this window also while I wait. So you can see now in the list, you have leadexplorer.se that I just added, and it's pending because it's not authenticated yet. You can use the drop list here to remove it. You can click the authenticate button here at any time. So once you get the word back from IT that they have done it, you go here, you click authenticate. I have done nothing now, so it shows me actually what is not added yet. And I can go back to IT if they missed a spot here. So once I have done that, it turns green, authenticated, and it's ready to be used on the system. So this is all you need to do if you're going to add a domain and authenticate it using your IT department. Just send it, wait for the okay, and authenticate. You're done. So if that's the way you're going to do it, feel free to stop watching here. Thank you for watching. But if you intend to add the DNS records yourself in your DNS, I'm going to show you how to do that. Because I'm going to do that with leadexplorer.se right now. Okay, so now let's do the full thing ourselves. We have added leadexplorer.se and now we're going to authenticate it, making the DNS changes. So I click the authenticate button again and I get all the values that I need to add in my DNS. I'm heading over to my actual DNS service provider. That's where I normally buy my domains and so on. It will look different on your end because there are as many service providers for DNS that there are domains, I think. But the good thing here is what we're going to do in the DNS is very, very basic, and you can do that in all DNS tools. So we're going to add two types of DNS entries. That's a text entry and a CNAME entry. So pretty basic. And all the values that we need to add are on this page. As you can see in my DNS right now, all I have is, it starts with the SPF. So there's a SPF record already on this account. And that's quite typical. It will be on your end also, and a lot of other records here. So just to the existing sets of records on your DNS for this domain, just add the value pair, the left side and the right side with the data. So on the left side, you can see that it's already assuming leadexplorer.se. So when I go to back to eMarketeer, these are all the rows that I need to add. It says create the CNAME record for, and I copy here because I can copy here also by just clicking this part, and now I've copied the entire string, but it was already assuming leadexplorer.se, so I'm going to copy it from here like that, paste it there, click the entire value on this row, paste it here. It wanted a CNAME and add. Next thing, do the same, another CNAME, there, CNAME. Right, so now we added all the standard parts. You need to all add these four rows that we did. Now we're on the SPF part, and SPF, I think that the majority of the cases you will already have a SPF record. But if you don't, you will just add Lead Explorer without anything, like on this row up here, and add this full value. SPF eMarketeer.com ?all. But if it's not, if it's already on there, you don't add a second SPF. There should be only one SPF record. So what you do is you take this part, include SPF1 eMarketeer.com. And in this part, you can see include SPFOutlook.com. I just put the marker after that, make a space and paste the eMarketeer part. DMARC is nothing you have to worry about here, because it's a company policy. It doesn't include only eMarketeer, and so that's a decision for your IT department or if you want to use it or not. It doesn't really affect deliverability with DMARC. It just lets you control and prevent people from using your domain fraudulently. All right, so once I've done this, I click authenticate, wait for the verification, and bam, leadexplorer.se is authenticated. I can show you what it looks like if it's not. You can see this other domain, which is still pending. Authenticate, I have done nothing here, but if I click authenticate, it will all turn red, or the rows that you have missed will turn red. So now I should have the new Lead Explorer domain available to choose from here. So let's go into my old email. Let's edit it. Let's look. Yeah, you can see here. Now I can choose leadexplorer.se. And even if I create a new email, let's go back to the campaign and add a new email. Ta-da, there's a new domain to be chosen there. Yeah, so that's all there is to it, actually. We have added domain, authenticated it, and you can do that over and over, as many domains as you have control over. If you're on the old email system, once you are happy with the list of domains you have authorized or authenticated, just send us an email at support@eMarketeer.com. and say that you're done, and we will activate the new email system on your account. So hope you enjoyed this guide, and happy eMarketeering!